So when they log in for the first time, they'll put in the proper, they'll put. Now that's it for this, but we.
Do you want to learn how to manage your Zoho One application? Well, in these tutorials, we're going to show you exactly how you can do that and the most important ways to go about managing it. In today's tutorial, we're going to show you how you can go about adding more users to your Zoho One account. So stay tuned and let's get started.
All right, so let's go ahead and add new users to our account. So if we go over here, click the settings icon again, now that we've logged in, we can go over to our users over here, then we can add in a new user. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna put in, let's just say user two. They don't have a last name. Let's say email address is user2@demo2.clientric.co. We have a couple settings here where we can generate a password for them, or we can force the user to change the password on login, or we could put in our own password if we want to. In this case, we're just gonna generate our own password over here, and we're gonna force the user to change the password when they first log in. So when they log in for the first time, they're gonna put in this password. As soon as they do that, Zoho One is gonna ask them to input a new password so that we don't have to worry about their password being stolen or incorrect or shared with anyone incorrectly. So we're gonna put that in there. We can add in a employee ID if you so chose. We can add in a designation, a department. We can say who they're reporting to. We can say where they're working. We also have the locale information. So we can say what language they're using, what country they're in, what time zone they're in, and then we have more specific information like date of birth, gender, the day they joined, and their seating location if that applies to you. Then most of the time this stuff probably won't be that big of a deal, so you'll probably just leave it for the most part. Then you can also add in custom fields. So in order to add in custom fields, there's nothing there yet. Now we could even say something along the lines of maybe credentials. So we want to track which credentials they have, and we can say a text, a checkbox, drop down, pick list, all these kinds of options. So let's say that we wanted them to have a BSc, let's see, a Bachelor's of Science, or maybe a PhD, whatever it might be. So we could have those options as well. So the credentials could be that. And then basically we just send them an email notification letting them know that we've added them to the account. Perfect. Now this individual has been created, user2@demo2.clientric.co. I can assign to an application, I can assign to various different groups, and I can also send the credentials to me. So this allows me to send the credentials to me so I can forward on to the new user, because they obviously don't have access to this account yet. So we'd want to send them the credentials so they knew how to log in with that information. Now we can also add more users straight from here. We could just select done. Now in this case, we want to assign maybe a few applications to user two. So we could go through, let's say analytics, we want to assign them an organization admin role. Done. Okay, so next we want to assign them to Zoho CRM. We want them to be maybe a manager. Right now this is all we have set up in Zoho CRM. So in this case, if it's a salesperson, we might have a sales role down here, or a support role, or whatever it is, and we could select that. In this case, I'm just going to select manager, and the profile would either be administrator or standard. Again, this is just because these are the options within CRM right now. We can always go ahead and change that in the future and manage it from the CRM side. So let's just click done there. And then for the last one, let's just add them to form. So they can either be a user, an admin, or a respondent. Let's add them as a user. Done. So we've just assigned three applications to them just so we can get them into some of these applications. Now we can also go ahead and edit this information. So if we come back here to the users tab, we're gonna see this user two. They haven't joined yet, so you can track that and make sure they have. You can remind them by email, and then you can also edit, assign the apps here, and even deactivate. Now when you deactivate, they will leave this list because this list just shows the active user list. So if we go back here, let's reload this. This user has been deactivated successfully. So let's go all users here. We want to see all users, and this is labeled as inactive. So that's important because you cannot see this under the active users list. We only have the active users and we have the inactive users. We also have access to pending users, confirmed, external, not invited, and not joined yet. So we can always add another user here. Or if you need to reactivate one of your users, maybe you accidentally deleted them, maybe they left and came back to your organization, or maybe you want to reuse someone's email. So let's go inactive here, and that we can activate down here this button. So we're going to activate this user again, and it's going to show up in the all users, and it's going to show up in the active users. So now we can go ahead and edit this user again. So we can see this information, we can add in anything we need. Let's just click update, that's great. Now we can also manage the email address. And so we can actually add in additional emails here by saying whatever domain we want. If we have other domains like demo2.clientric.co, clientric.com, clientric.ca, you can choose which one they can also be added to. And then we also have the option other, which allows us to put in, let's say, a Gmail email account as well. So that is how you go about adding more. And this star over here denotes that this is the primary email address. So when you're using your email account, this is the email address that's being sent from. And now that's it for the manage email address. We can exit over there. We can also reset the password. So we can generate a new password and let them know. We can email the new password to the users. We can clear mobile sessions and API tokens. And that's it for the password section over here. So we're just going to cancel that. And then we also have the ability to reset the multi-factor authentication. Now this only needs to be reset if you're using it. Not everyone uses the multi-factor authentication. It is best security practices to do that, but it can also add an extra layer of complexity, especially if maybe you're sharing some logins with external third parties or whatever it might be. So that's how you manage your users, add users, and make sure they have access to the things they need. In the next tutorial, we're going to dive more into the applications and adding applications to your users. So I hope that's been helpful. And by now, I'm sure you're aware that we're trying to reach as many people as possible who need to see this information. So be sure that you are liking and commenting on all these videos, subscribing to our channel. That really helps us reach more people and allows us to get the word out on how to use Zoho, because we are big fans of it ourselves. And as always, make sure you're subscribing to our other social channels like Instagram and Facebook. We are building an awesome community and we can't wait to see you there. Bye for now.